Hello there, I am Nathalie, and today we are going to create a 3D t-shirt using Audaces Fashion Studio software. By the end of this video, you'll be able to see your piece on the runway and share it with whoever you want. In this video, you're gonna make the step-by-step process until you have your digital t-shirt ready. If you haven't downloaded Audaces Fashion Studio yet, you can download the freemium version clicking on the link below. So let's get started. To start the creation of our shirt, let's click on Start Creating. Then you must select the mannequin you want to work with, and in this example I'm going to use the 2022 male and click OK. The mannequin will be loaded in the system. To have a better view, click with the right mouse button and drag to spin it and have a 360 view. To move the mannequin over the workspace, click and drag it to wherever you want. To zoom in a specific area, move the cursor there and scroll the mouse wheel. To start the design, you must delimit the work area and the parts you're going to work with. For this, you must cut the shirt border. Using the Creations tab, cut with ring tool. Then select with the left mouse button the height you want to cut and confirm it with the right mouse button. Now select the bottom part and click the trash can icon or the delete key to remove it and isolate the shirt. Now the shirt I'm going to use in this example has dropped shoulders. So you need fabric to work this shoulder drop. For that, click the symmetry plan button so everything you make in a side is duplicated in the other. Select the pinch tool. To increase or decrease, roll the mouse scroll where this is going to be applied. Click, hold and drag to give this visualization and increase the amount of fabric. To make the sleeve, you must click here and move it down with the same tool to make some volume and make the sleeve. After the volume is created, you must let this shirt part uniform. For that, you must use the smooth tool with just a little strength. Click, hold and drag to give some form to it. Now you can cut the dropped shoulder. Use the cut with ring tool. Now you can see that the cut is being duplicated in the other side. Move it to where you want to make the armhole. To increase or decrease the ring, use the mouse wheel, scrolling up or down. Click wherever you want to select the cut place and confirm with the right mouse button. Now you already have your dropped shoulder and can use the same angle to limit the sleeve. After selecting it, use the right mouse button to confirm. Now to delete the parts you're not going to use, click them with the mouse while pressing the shift key. Then click the trash can icon or use the delete key. Now you can give some volume to the shirt sides. To make it, you're going to use the pinch tool to click, hold and drag it out to give volume so you have fabric to work with. And now you must use the simulate tool with gravity so the fabric will automatically loose and receive form as if affected by gravity. You can also create more gravity if you want more looseness, clicking the gravity tool and dragging the looseness bar. After that, you can adjust some unwanted volume with the smooth tool. You can apply it on the sides, the back and the shirt hem. Once it's done, you can work on the neck part. To make it, you need more fabric to cut it more uniformly. To apply more fabric, you must use the expand border tool. Click and drag the speed bar. After creating more fabric, you can use the cut with ring tool. But before, you must know that our body is angular than this straight angle of the software. To make other angles, you need to press the Ctrl key and use the angles that appear. The yellow ring is the main ring, the red is used to move up and down, while the blue ring is for moving right and left. Now click and drag the red ring to make the angle. You can check it better on sideways. In the front part, you must click here with the left mouse button and confirm with the right mouse button. Click and confirm again here. You can click here and delete this part that you're not going to use. If you think that the neck is too high, you can drag it down with a pinch tool. Select the neck, click, hold and drag it down to have a new angle. If you want to fix some lines, use again the smooth tool, while pressing the shift key. Also, you can use the expand border tool to expand the neck fabric. Now you have the shirt base done and you must separate front and back part. First, select the body, spin it sideways, click cut with ring tool, increase the ring size scrolling up the mouse wheel, and while pressing the control key, click, hold and drag to reach the shirt side. Don't forget to control and adjust the angle. Click and confirm, and now you separated the front and back parts. Now you must select and cut the sleeves. For that, use again the cut with ring tool. Roll the red ring. Remove the snap so you can angle it better. Click and confirm. If you don't need the cut above, you can select remove it using the remove cuts tool and clicking once the cut line. Now you have a cut under the sleeve, the front part and the back part of the shirt. Now for the neck part, you're going to make a cut here in the back part. This cut can also be made with the cut with ring tool. Press Ctrl, click, hold and drag to angle straight. To have a straight angle, you must use Enable Snap tool and it will help reaching the straight angle. When you have it, click and confirm. Now you have the cuts you need. This shirt part is now done and now you must select all the meshes to apply the texture. For that, you must click the Application tab, then the Fabric Texture button, the texture you want to use, and finally the Apply button. It is going to be applied to all the pieces. You can control how it is going to be applied. Then clicking this Resize tool, you can change the size from smaller to bigger. You can turn it with the Turn tool and move it with the Move Texture tool. After that, you can change the neck texture. To do so, select the neck and then the meshes. After that, open again the Application tool and then the Mesh button. Select the texture option you want and click Apply. Now you can resize, spin, increase or decrease size, and then the neck is applied. To have a better view of the pieces, you can remove the lines visualization. For that, you open the Border tab, select all the meshes, click in the first one, Shift, and click the last one. Then click on Enable the Draw Border Outline box. Now you can have a better view of the shirt. Now you must apply the seam part. For that, you must click the tools that show the additions and visualization. Use the Ctrl and Shift keys on the lines you want to add the seam, which in this example is the top stitch. Click the seam and zipper button. Select the seam you want and then click Apply. It will be applied and in the preview tab, you can move the back stitch place. Select if it's single, double or triple line. Use these additions to modify the size, the spacing and so on. You can click here to change color. And I'm going to use purple in this example. You can go back to the visualization mode and now you have your seam together with your fabric texture visualization. Let's apply a print. Select the front part in the addition mode, open the application tab, click the mesh print button, select the print you want to apply, click open, click in the place you want to paste the print. Cancel, select it again, edit as you want. You can change size, orientation, and place. Apply it and the shirt is done. Clicking on Open on Runway, you are able to see your piece on a digital runway. Now you have your final piece and you can play around and change colors, prints, textures of your t-shirt. Hope this tutorial inspired you to continue having fun and creating. Don't forget to comment below and I'll see you on our next tutorial. Bye bye!